Hi, Chuck Huber here for the State of YouTube channel. Today I'd like to show you how to fit a logistic regression model with a continuous covariate. I'm going to show you how to fit the model, test some parameters, estimate some marginal predictions, and then create some plots for our model. So I'm going to be using the NHANES 2L dataset, and you can download this from the State of Servers by typing web use NHANES 2L. And here I've described the two variables that we'll be using for this model. High BP is an indicator for high blood pressure, and age, measured in years, is a continuous covariate that we'll be using. So let's begin by going to Statistics, and then I'm going to select Binary Outcomes, and then click Logistic Regression. So for my dependent variable, I'm going to select the binary predictor, or excuse me, binary indicator high blood pressure, high BP. And then for my independent variable, I'm going to click this little three-dot box here. And I'm going to leave factor variable selected at the top, along with the main effect specification. So I'm going to select my variable here, age. And then there's a little checkbox here underneath C dot. I'm going to check this box, and that tells Stata that age is a continuous variable, explicitly tells Stata that that's a continuous variable. I'm not going to use any time series operators, and we're going to ignore base for now. And I'm just going to click add to var list. So now I'm going to click OK. And now age appears in my list of independent variables. So when I click OK, the dialog box issues the command logistic, followed by our binary dependent variable, high BP, followed by age, which Stata assumes to be continuous. Now, and if I look at my output here, I see some model level statistics. I see the number of observations, the likelihood ratio chi-square, its p-value, along with a pseudo r-squared. And then I also see an odds ratio for the intercept as well as the variable age, along with their standard errors, z statistics, p-values, and 95% confidence interval. So let me show you a couple of tricks that you can do with continuous covariates. First off, I'm just going to click the command in the history window, and that sends it back to the command window. If I want to explicitly tell Stata that age is continuous, I can type a C dot in front of age. And that tells Stata explicitly that age is continuous. Doesn't change the output in this case because Stata already assumed it was continuous. But here's another fun thing I can do. I'm going to hit page up to bring my command back up in the command window. I can type two little sharps here, or hashtags, whatever you want to call them, and then type c.age again. So what this is shorthand for, it's telling Stata that age is continuous. And then the two little hashtag operators here tell Stata that I'd like to see the main effect of age, as well as the interaction of age with itself, which is equivalent to creating a squared term in the model. So I'll have age and age squared in my model. So if I press enter, now I have an age term in my model, and I also have an age squared term in my model. Okay, and that may or may not be necessary. It depends on whether you have a linear or a curvilinear relationship between age and high blood pressure. If we look at the p-values, we see that both of those p-values are very small, and if I wanted to test them simultaneously, I can come back to the command window, and I'm going to type test parm, and then c.age, because I want to test the linear term, as well as c.age, and then one hashtag, and then c.age again. So that will test the interaction term. I left out a c there. And what that's going to do is test that both the linear age term and the quadratic age term, that those coefficients are simultaneously equal to zero, or that their odds ratios are simultaneously equal to one. So that will report a chi-square statistic as well as a p-value for that test. So these odds ratios look fairly small. And so one thing that's nice to do after you fit models like this is to estimate marginal predictions to get some idea of whether that's an important magnitude or not. So I'm going to go to statistics here and then scroll almost all the way to the bottom here where it says post estimation. So I'll select that. And this opens Stata's post estimation selector. This allows me to do all kinds of things like goodness of fit analysis, predictions, tests, contrasts, and so forth. I want to do some marginal predictions, so I'm going to check this box and expand this menu next to marginal effects, estimated means, and interactions. And I want to do some basic stuff for now, so I'm going to select basic and low dimensional analysis and then click launch. And this opens Stata's margins dialog box. So here at the top in the main tab, I need to select the type of covariate, and I have a continuous covariate, so I'm going to select continuous. And then for my covariate, I only have one in the model, and that's age. And I want to estimate marginal means of the outcome for levels of the covariate. There are other things that I could do, but let's just keep this fairly simple. And then I need to specify values to compute the estimates at. So I'd like to estimate marginal predictions at age 20 in increments of 10 years through 80. So 20 and then 10 and 80, the 10 being in parentheses, tells Stata that I want to see predictions at 20 years of age through 80 years of age in increments of 10 years. So I'm going to leave all of that and click OK. And now if I move this over, I can see that the dialog box issued the command margins. And then I have the option here, comma at age equals 20 through 80 in increments of 10 years. And if I look at the output, it shows me that some expressions. So expression at 1 refers to age equals 20. At 2 refers to age equals 30, and so forth through age equals 80. So if I look at my output, what I see then are the predicted probability of hypertension, high blood pressure, at 1 or at age equals 20. So the predicted probability of hypertension at age 20 is about 0.13 rounded. At age 80, which is at 7, the predicted probability of hypertension is about 0.70 rounded. And for each of those predicted probabilities, I get a standard error, a z-test, a p-value, as well as a 95% confidence interval. Now, that's fun, but let's take a look at how to plot these. It can be very informative to plot these. So I'm going to select Profile Plots After Marginal Analysis. So I'm going to click Launch, and this opens the Margins Plot dialog box. So in the main tab, I'm going to select the variable that defines the x-axis. So that's going to be at age. Okay, and then I'm going to click Submit. And what this will show me is a plot of those marginal predictions. So the horizontal axis is age at age 20, 30, 40, 50 through 80 in increments of 10. And the vertical axis is the predicted probability of hypertension. So at each of those ages, it's going to show me a dot for the predicted probability of hypertension and put a confidence interval around that prediction. And then it connects those with a line. So this makes it really easy to visualize the results of our model. Okay. So let me show you a fun trick that I can do after I fit this model. I'm going to close these dialog boxes and come over here to the history window. So I'm going to right-click any line here in the history window and select all. And then I'm going to right-click again and select Send Selected to Do File Editor. And what that will do is send all of those commands that we generated with the dialog boxes to a do file. And I can save this file, and then I can rerun my analysis over and over again so it's reproducible. It also allows me to see all of those options for the commands that I used. So it's a good way to learn new commands and options as well. So that's how we can fit logistic regression models with continuous predictor variables, test some hypotheses, estimate marginal predictions, and create some plots from our graphs. So I hope this was helpful. Thanks for stopping by.